think critical concept, actually not that critical, we'll use the same formulas, called half-life of a reaction. So it is the time in which the concentration of reactant, first thing, half-life is nothing but it is time, right? This is time when my concentration of reactant is reduced to half of initial concentration. So you see, this was my initial concentration and this becomes half. So the time it took, let's suppose this is my reactant, this was my reactant. The concentration of reactant goes half, that, and the time it takes is t half, denoted by t half. T 1 by 2 is my subscript. So let's find T half for both zero order and first order reaction. So we know that, let's do this. Now for zero order reaction, we know that K is nothing but R naught by R by T. R naught is initial concentration, final concentration by time taken. So T half is when my R becomes half of R2, right? This is my final concentration, R is my final concentration. So at T half, R is nothing but half of R2, R naught. Right? R naught is my initial concentration, R is my final concentration. So T half is when my final concentration becomes half of initial concentration. Let's put the values. K is equal to R naught minus R naught by 2 by T half. Or you solve, you get T half as R naught by 2. Now if you see, T half is directly proportional to initial concentration and T half is inversely proportional to rate constant. Please note here, T half directly proportional to initial concentration and T half is inversely proportional to rate constant. Please remember this formula. You'll be using this formula. Or actually, you don't need to remember, if you remember just this formula. But to solve the questions faster, it's good that you remember this formula. Correct? Now let's find the same thing for first order reaction. First order. First order, we know the formula K is nothing but 2.303 by T log of R naught by R. Please remember these two formulas are very critical. This is for the zeroth order reaction. K is equal to R naught minus R by T. And for this first order reaction, K is equal to 2.303 by T log of R naught by R. Here we'll put the values. The same values at T half, R is equal to R naught by 2. So 2 point, or this I can say, or K is equal to 2.303, instead of T I'll use T half, log of R naught will be same, and R I'll make it as nothing but R naught by 2. So this becomes log of 2, right? If you actually solve it, becomes 0.693 by T half, or I can say that T half is nothing but 0.693 by K. A very good equation. And if you see here, in this case the half-life is independent of initial concentration. There is no initial concentration in this and it is inversely proportional to rate constant. In zero order reaction, T half is inversely proportional to rate constant, but it was directly proportional to initial concentration. In my first order reaction, the half-life of this reaction is independent of the initial concentration. And that's a very, very critical observation. Please note, T half is 0.693 by K. It is totally independent of initial concentration for first order reaction. But my zero order reaction, T half, you see, is directly proportional to initial concentration. But there is no initial concentration figure here. T half is 0.693 by k. This is also a very useful formula. We generally use it because a lot of equations we use is first order equation, and there we have to find the half life. So we directly use this formula. T half is 0.693 by k. If you don't remember the formula, if you remember this formula, you can actually derive it in one step. So the most important formulas which we should remember, you can actually derive them, but you should remember are these two formulas. This is more important for the first order reaction, the value of k, and this for the zero order reaction, the value of k. This is pretty easy, right? Initial concentration minus final concentration by t. That is nothing but k. We'll take some numericals now. A first order reaction, the first thing is that this first order reaction is found to have rate constant k is given. This is 10 to the power minus 14 per second. So just by looking at the rate constant unit only, I can make out it is a first order reaction. So even if this is not given, if it says a reaction is found to have rate constant this, you can actually tell it is a first order reaction looking at the units. Find the half life of the reaction. We just derived the formula for first order reaction. T half is nothing but 0.693 by k. Just put the formula values here. 0.693 by k is 5.5 10 to the power minus 14 per second. Solve this, you get 1.26 into 10 to the power 14 second. So that is the half life of this particular reaction. Right, this is the time it took for concentration to become half. We have to show that the first order reaction, the time requires to complete 99.9% is 10 times the T half of the reaction. See, in first, there are two cases. Case one, my R is nothing but 99% complete. The reaction is 99% complete. That is R naught minus 9, this R. No. That is nothing but 0.001 R naught. This is my first case. In case two, my final concentration is half of initial concentration. That is my T half. Right, there are two conditions. So we have to show that the time required in both the cases has a relationship of 10 times. So let's find the time required in both the cases. Case one, the formula we know is k is 2.303 by t log of r naught by r. Correct? So t will become what? T is 2.303 by k log of r naught by r. R naught, r is what here? R is 0.001 r naught. Correct. You solve, there is nothing but 6.909 by in the first case. Case 2, I directly know T half is nothing but 0.6903 by k. I can directly use the formula. Right? This is my T1 and this is my, let's suppose, T2. This is my T half. Now let's see a relation between T1 and 2. If you see, this is 6.909 by k and this is 0.6903 by k. I can say that T1 is nothing but 10 times of T2. If you don't know this, what you can do is, this is, let's suppose, equation 1 and equation 2. You just divide these two equations. You get T1 by T2 is nothing but 6.909 by k divided by 0.6903 by k. And that will come out to be nothing but 10. Thus, you can say that T1 by T2 is 10. There is nothing but T1 is equal to 10 times T2. Pretty easy. See, in both the case, just find the time it takes and derive the relationship between them. Correct. Let's do a recap of what we have seen. We have focused on two types of reactions, zeroth order and the first order. In both case we have reactant to product kind of equation. Both has two different differential law. In this case it was dr by dt is minus k, because it was to the power 0. Here dr by dt is minus k into r to the power 1. That was the differential rate law. In this case my kt was nothing but r naught minus r. We just told k is nothing but r naught minus r by t. That is a very critical formula. And in this case we use this equation, k is nothing but 2.303 by this formula we use only, 2.303 by t log of r naught by r. Instead of 2.303 they have used ln, right? So write both the equation. K in this case it is k is r naught minus r by t. The same thing, kt is equal to r naught minus r, and in this case this is the formula. Instead of ln, if you see, we have used 2.303 into log. And if you talk about the plotting of the graph, right, r versus t is a straight line. If you see, r versus t is a straight line constant. Here ln r versus t will be a straight line, because if you see, kt is nothing but something in the form of ln, right? Half life we have seen is ln 2 by k, that is nothing but 0.6093 by k, and here it is r naught by 2k. And if you talk about the units, since it is a first order, it is unit is per second or per time, per minutes per hour, and here it is moles per liter per second.